Welcome to my short video showing you how to install and configure all the tools and software required for building all the projects for Raspberry Pi Pico, which you can find in my videos, including those with Intel 8188 computer, because we're using the Pico as our multi-IO card. Some of the tools we will be installing here are common for both the Pico toolchain set and also the Intel 16-bit toolchain. So obviously you need to do this once, even if you want to set up for both. I'm using Windows Sandbox, which is a feature of Windows 11, which allows you to start from scratch, like you would run your Windows for the first time after installing. So it's completely clean. It doesn't have any contamination from my already configured tool sets. The only thing I did in this session is to add all the tabs in the web browser to speed up downloading all the tools. All the links used in this video will be, of course, included in the description. And if you're a fan of winget, the command line tool for installing packages, I will be listing all the available tools in winget as well, so you will see them on screen. Obviously we need to start with the Arm toolchain, which we need to download. The only important thing in choosing those is to use the bare metal target, so Arm non-EABI. You can either use the zip file or the exe file. I'm gonna just download the exe. Once it's downloaded, let's just run the installer. On the last screen, the important thing which saves us one step would be to tick add path, so we don't need to do this manually, and finish. So that's done, let's close it down. The next one is the Pico SDK. It's on GitHub, so you can clone the repo using Git, but I'll just, for this quick video, download the zip file. Once we open it, we need to unzip it into a folder. I'm gonna use maybe separate folder called tools, because there will be more coming in, and unzip the whole folder with the SDK. Now that's quite important. We need to go inside the folder and copy the whole path, then open the system properties. So run sysdm.cpl. That's the quickest way to go there. Advanced environment variables, and let's create a new one. The new one will be called capitalized Pico underscore SDK underscore path. It is for the tools to find it easily, and paste the full path to where we unzipped the SDK. That's it for now. Let's keep this window because we'll need it later. So that's done. Next is the Python. We're not gonna use Python directly, but the SDK uses it. So let's download the version for Windows and just simply install it. We can add Python to path. All right, it has installed, so we're done with it. Now we need to download the make for Windows in order to build our source codes. Okay, and let's install it. Make is common for both the Intel 16-bit toolchain and this one, so if you follow the other video and you already have installed make, don't need to do this here. just remember that after installing, we need to add it to the system path. So we need to go and find it in program files, then GNU in 32 bin, and copy the whole path and add it here to the variable called path. A new one, paste, go. And we're done here. The next one is the GCC for Windows for our Intel processor, but not the 16-bit one, the one we have in our computers. That's because the SDK contains some tools, Windows tools, which need to be built as a part of the process. So we need this as well. If we just scroll down, choose the newest version. We're not using LLVM, so we can choose the version without any of the LLVM clang and so on. And so we will choose Windows 64-bit version, why not? Zip archive. And when it downloads, let's open the zip and unpack it to our C tools folder. Okay, once we've unzipped the GCC, let's go into the folder just unpacked and go to the bin level and then copy the path and add it again to the system path. So path, edit, add a new one, and just paste the copied path. And then okay, we're done with this step. Let's close it down. CMake, we need CMake as well as for the Intel 16-bit development. So if you've done it following the other video, you don't need to do this, but let's do this now. CMake simple installer, just go next, and here make sure you choose the option to add the path to the system path and go and install it. Okay, we're done. We can close down the page. And now the VS Code, which we use to edit the code. Also, it integrates with CMake, so it makes everything very easy. Just you can build everything with one press of the button. Let's go download. And install it. It just lets us know that we are administrators and this is the user setup. If you want, you can choose to use the system installer version, which installs for all users. I'll just go with that one. After it's installed, launch it. Let me just make the window slightly larger, just don't care. And let's go to the extensions. And what we need to find is called C++ extension pack, like that, by Microsoft. Let's install that. It's got all the C++ and CMake integration inside, so it's going to be very easy to build everything using VS Code. Okay, it looks like it's installed. We can close it down for now. And it's all the tools. Now we let's just use my repo for the Raspberry Pi Pico and download the zip with the whole code, open it, and let's say we'll unzip it into the C and let's say SRC folder. That's just an example. You can unzip into any folder you like. Once it's done, we open VS Code. and then click on Open Folder, choose the one you just used to unzip, and go to the PIO Explained, select Folder. Yes, I do trust. And now the first thing which should happen is to the menu to choose the kit should appear. If it doesn't, you can always click at the bottom here and choose the ARM non-EABI. We also have this native GCC compiler, but we're choosing the ARM one. Once it's chosen, you can let's wait until it's done, and then just press F7, and it should start the build. It will take a while for the first time because it needs to build all the tools which are used during the compilation process, but now we're done. It says it's completed and it created an executable. In this case, the example was to do with the LEDs, WS2812, that's how the project was named. So if you go to the same folder here, PIO Explained, and then Build, you will see the binaries in there. The ELF mentioned here, but that's just a Linux executable file. To program Pico, you use the UF2 file, which you just drag over after connecting Pico with the button on the Pico pressed, which creates the kind of memory stick drive on your system. Then you just copy the UF2 file onto that drive, and it's that's how you program the Pico. So that's effectively it. If you followed this video, you are now set up to develop your software or build the software I am using in my videos for Raspberry Pi Pico. Thank you for watching, and see you soon.